So a football club is not a marketing product. It's not a consumer product. It's something much more important. And you cannot manufacture a brand or a history of a club. So the first thing that I had to learn is, who are we? So what's the essence of Manchester City? And I think this one is very, very easy to learn. Very easy. You just have to look at the history of this club and how this club was born. And it tells you everything. It was the daughter of a vicar in the Church of St. Mark who decided that, you know, more than 100 years ago, it was a bad idea for boys and for men to fight and to drink after work. And they created the family that was running the St. Mark's Church. They created a cricket club and a football club. And this is who we are. And as amazing as it seems, you look at the core of this football club today and the way people think about this football club and the way people behave, and it comes from that fact. We are a community club. We are a club of the community. We were a club of the community of Manchester. Our challenge and what we do every day, and I can guarantee you that we spend a lot of time thinking about how do we take this to the 21st century and to a global world. So what is the equivalent of the daughter of the vicar today? What is the equivalent of creating a football club to help young people develop themselves? And we work very hard on that. And everything we do is guided by this, because this is who we are. And this is the only way we will be successful and recognized and valuable in the world, is if we are true to who we are. Doesn't mean being linked to the past and do the things the same way that were done 100 years ago. Of course not. This is the challenge. The challenge is to find a way to be a community club in the 21st century. And we're doing pretty well. When you look at City in the Community, and you look at what they do for young people in Manchester and now around the world, it's pretty amazing. And we are more global, I can say that, we are more global than any other football club in the world, by far. And we can do that. It's possible. In the world of football, you can be local and you can be global. And we are local because we are rooted in Manchester. And we are global because we have people in this room coming from Vancouver, Dallas, Hollywood, New York. And they all share the same passion. And I wanna say something that I know some people don't like. And I'm gonna tell you why some people don't like. Because from time to time I find a City fan that tells me, I've been through all the ups and downs. More downs than ups. And the typical expression is, I was in Mangersfield. Listen, everybody that told me that was in Mangersfield was really in Mangersfield, they have Wembley Stadium. That can't be true. Can't be true. But I get what they mean. So actually, myself, I had to look at the map and find matters. But I get what they meant. This club was in difficult situations years ago, and you were all there. And that makes this club special. But the people that are following us, the people that love Manchester City today, from Dallas, from Shanghai, they're also part of the family. This is the beauty of it. This is why this is so amazing. And there's no better job in the world than the job that we do. Yesterday, actually, the day before yesterday, on Tuesday, I was in Dallas. I was in Dallas for a meeting, and I had to watch the game. So I don't know if you can imagine what it is to be in Dallas and watch a football game. But the first problem is I went to a bar and said, I want to watch football. And they look at me and say, there's no football today. Okay, so soccer. I mean soccer. So I went to a bar, I was alone, watching the game, miserable, without sound, suffering. You know, when I saw Vincent Kompany falling on the floor, I could sense your silence. You were all silent. But as time passed by, there were more and more people that were coming and sitting with me, watching soccer and watching Manchester City. And I think we can embrace that. We can be, you are the core of this club. The supporters clubs represent what the club is, the community that support each other and that gets together to support the team. I think we can embrace, in this community, we can embrace people living all over the world and following our club. And, you know, in the 3.5 years that I've been here, I've seen lots of great things. I think one of the most important is I've seen the birth of a family. We have a club in New York. We have a team in Melbourne. We have another sister in Yokohama, in Japan. And I was in New York last week for the first game of the season. And there was somebody from Manchester with me that at some point in time said, you know, I didn't get, why are we doing this? Why are we creating a team in New York? And I can guarantee you that that person and all of you, if you would have been with me in New York last Sunday with thousands of people dressed in sky blue, rooting for the team, New York City, you would have felt something very special. And my way to illustrate this with my colleague who was saying, why are we doing this? I said, okay, so think about it. How would you feel if you would be walking around the stadium in New York, seeing 30,000 people dressed in red, supporting New York United? What we are doing is great, and it helps Manchester City, and it takes Manchester City to the 21st century. It takes us to be global while we are still and will always be local and rooted in Manchester. And this is the challenge. The challenge is how to continue to have the spirit of the daughter of the vicar while we compare the world. And if you think about it, I know we're all nervous about a game on Sunday and we want to win all the games and we don't win all the games. But in the last 3 years, I've seen 3 trophies. I've seen the best football academy in the world being opened. I've seen the birth of 2 new football clubs, Melbourne City and New York City. I've seen the expansion of the Etihad Stadium. It's pretty amazing. It's pretty amazing. You know what the most important is? The future. If we have done this in such a short period of time, what can we do in the next 3 years, in the next 5 years, in the next decade? I hope we will be all here and able to celebrate. Thank you.